Action, we're on. Take one.
Action, okay. The first thing we did was learn our chords. C, D minor, E minor, F, F major 7, G7, A minor, and then B diminished. Now, I gave each one of those chords a character description. C's happy, D minor sad, E minor sad, F major 7th is kind of mellow, but still kind of happy. G7th is very happy, like I just found some money. Then I go back to my A minor, which is sad, and the B diminished we call dissonant. So I try to run those chords in order. That's the idea. Now I do a scale for each one of those chords. C is C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, and backwards. Using the right fingers with the right portion. Mm-hmm. So I use finger 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, fret 2, fret 3, fret 4. Now that gives me enough room to. Because each one of my fingers a ninth amount of exercise. So I did a chord, a scale. Now do an arpeggio. I describe that as going sharp, move here with a stack. And that fixes up my chord, scale, arpeggio for C. I do the same thing in minor. Take the D minor chord and go D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D. Then I fix my arpeggio with those notes. 1, 3 flat, 5, 1, 3 flat, 5. That's how I do a major to a minor. The E minor, it's the same thing. You remember your rule about an E to F. You take that note right there, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E. And the arpeggio is still the same. 1, 3 flat, 5, 1, 3 flat, 5, 1. F major 7th. It's that mellow chord. You know, I hear that all the time. It's a good jazz chord. And my scale is F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F. So you see the two half steps falling right here. So the major, the arpeggio is a major 7th. It goes 1, 3, 5, 7, 3, 5. That's the one you had a little trouble with, but now you should be able to define that. So I have an F major 7th, an F scale, and an F arpeggio majored. Now I go to G7. G scale, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So you follow the rule there. And the arpeggio falls off of this note. 1, 3, 5, 7 flat, 3, 5, 1. They go to A minor. A minor is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. And that's just called an Aeolian scale, but you're looking at 1, whole step, whole step, whole step. So it's pretty easy. That's just one step off from Phrygian. So they're really similar. Now the arpeggio is still like the one at the minor. A, 1, 3 flat, 5, 1, 3 flat, 5, 1. So this one, the one that you did here, is the same one here. Those all work the same. Same as the E minor. Those were all exactly the same. Same position for the arpeggios. The diminished one is kind of weird. It starts at B, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B. The arpeggio is kind of weird. I don't like it. I don't really use it a lot. It's very low on my list.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now that I have that together, what I'm going to try to do is move that scale back and forth with the right fingers. Now, if I want to play in minors like you like playing in a minor, I'll take this 1, 2, flatten the third, which is a rule that makes that minor sad. 1, 3, 5, I mean 1, 2, 3 flat, 4, 5, 6 will now be a 6 flat. 7 will now be a 7 flat. So the scale looks like this. 1, 2, 3 flat, 4, 5, 6 flat, 7 flat, 1. Now watch my minor arpeggio. The diagonal showed up. Then you move yourself to bentonic blues box position 1. We already know what you do here. I'll show you some techniques of triplet, which you did good on. We did a unison bend here. Then we did electus. Then I did a combination of bend, rake, hammer on, pull off, bend. Then I did a compound, which you call that chicken picking. So a combined combination. Electus, triplets. I have trills, bends. I have small, medium, and large. Then you have your micro bend. Now, when you're doing your bends in your blues box, you have position 1 here, position 2 here, position 3 here. Did I miss anything?
Don't think.
Okay. That's your mission. That's your week's worth of practicing.
Cool.
And I saw you do.